setting him up, and the last prey falls as he hits him with that boot. Cover, 1, 2, it's over. With that win, Darren Payne and Baron Corbin again prove why they are probably the most dominant tag team in wrestling today. And it's gonna be a damn tough time for any team that tries to oppose these two. Ethan Alexander going up top. Here comes Ethan. Oh my God! What the hell? What the heck just happened? Super kick. And now, pop up powerbomb! As he picks him up with the Apocalypse now. What the hell? Wait a second. That's Luka Khan. That's ZCW's newest. This is ZCW's newest rookie, Luka Khan. Oh no, the effect is following. Alright. Powerbomb position! It's like it. What is he doing? What is he doing? Oh my God! Oh Jesus! Oh no! Oh no! A very, very impressive win for Kota Ibushi. That's more personal than... Wait a minute! What the heck? Sami Callihan! Sami Callihan! Oh my God! Not, oh my God! Oh, he busted open Dean Ambrose with that chair shot. No! 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 Someone's got to get help for Ambrose. Someone has got to do something. This is sick. Wait a second, no. Bill Martinez back to his feet. And again, another attitude adjustment. Could this be it? Yeah, it is. Finally able to get a win here in ZCW after months and months of trying. One more time. Orton down. Boom. I-A. Count. 1, 2, 3. That's Roman. That's Roman Reigns. That's Roman. Oh my goodness. He just... Roman Reigns. What is he doing? Not going to let them go. Spear. And hits him with the Rainmaker. Wait a second. Rollins got back in the ring. Rollins got back in the ring. And out goes Okada. Out goes Okada. Rollins, out of nowhere, 1, 2, and over, new ZCW champion. But this night belongs to Seth Rollins. Thank you everyone for joining us here for ZCW Takedown. Hello there everyone, my name is Zaiah Morgan. I am the official commentator here for ZCW, and we are just coming off a spectacular pay-per-view at ZCW Takedown. And what a way to start off the show. We've got the ZCW General Manager Mack Waters. It's to my attention that he has came out here because he has a special announcement to address to the crowd. One can only speculate what that announcement could be, but Mack Waters has promised us that it's an exciting one, and one that all of the ZCW roster is going to want to hear. See Mack Waters getting ready to address the crowd. Thank you. Oh, no. Well, here comes the man who might have just permanently taken out Dean Ambrose from in-ring competition, Sami Callihan, at ZCW Takedown. Before the match even got started, Sami Callihan coming from behind and attacking Dean Ambrose with not just multiple chair shots, but multiple headlock drivers onto the top of the ramp. It's to my understanding that Dean Ambrose has been taken out of competition effective immediately. Dates to when his return is, we're not even sure, and we're not even sure if he'll be back, but it seems like Sami Callihan has something to say to Mr. Waters. Who is it? Mr. Waters just said that Sami Callihan has a qualifying match up. Oh my god. Well, I'm pretty sure this is probably the last person Sami Callihan would want to see right now. It's Mil Muertes. The man from beyond the grave, the man who also lost his last man standing match against John Cena at ZCW Takedown. So you know, Mil Muertes is probably not in the best of moods right now. As you can see that look on his face, that I think that's going to come into fruition once he gets into that ring with Sami Callihan. If I were Sami Callihan, I would think of a strategy and quick, because God only knows what kind of sort of destruction this man has planned for anyone that tries to step up to Mil Muertes. He's Sami Callihan, you can see he's ready, and so is Mil Muertes. The ref rings the bell, and oh, wait a second, here comes Callihan! Callihan coming right after Mil Muertes, striking away, getting that early advantage on Mil Muertes, but Mil Muertes coming right back with a boot to the chest. So much for that strategy. And now Morta is going to lay down a beating on Callahan. He's just striking away at Callahan in the corner and now just delivering those boots to Callahan. I said it earlier, this is Mil Muertes not in the best of moods after losing his match to John Cena at Takedown. Now what if this sends Callahan off the ropes? Callahan trying to go for a clothesline, not getting it. Oh my god! A huge lariat by Mil Muertes, completely turning Sammy Callahan inside out, and now with a big splash! What a big body slashing. Oh, we saw this at Takedown 2. Oh, and there's a second body splash. And could he be going for the trifecta here? Off the ropes again, and a big splash into the cover. He might have just flattened Sammy Callahan too. No, it's not it. Sammy Callahan with a lot more fight than all, but gets taken down with that huge shoulder tackle. A belly suplex. This has been mostly Mil Muertes. Sammy Callahan is in a world of trouble right now. This is a more pissed off Mil Muertes than we're used to seeing here in ZCW. And considering that Mil Muertes is usually not a happy camper, that's saying a lot. Oh my god, look at the height of that powerbomb! Uh-oh. He's setting Callahan up in that corner. He's setting him up. Is he gonna hit that devastating spear? No! Callahan getting out of the ring. Not dealing with any of that. Gonna count away at Callahan. Callahan looking at the ring, looking at Mil Muertes. He wants absolutely nothing to do with Mil Muertes. Wait a second. Callahan walking up the ramp. Is Callahan leaving the match? It looks like he's about to walk up that ramp. Oh, wait a second. Callahan now walking back to the ring. Mil Muertes is inviting him back into the ring. And Callahan decides not today. And Mil Muertes just keeps on telling Callahan to get back into his ring. Callahan, like I said, wants nothing to do with Mil Muertes. We're at a count of nine. And yeah, it's over. Sammy Callahan doing the smartest thing and getting out of Mil Muertes' way. So an easy win for Mil Muertes, but for Sammy Callahan, he may have lost a shot at the ZCW World title, but he still can go for the ZCW Pride title come Battle of the Gods.
The following contest is a Battle of the Gods qualifying match scheduled for one fall, winning his way down the main first. from Salt Lake City, Utah, 184 pounds, Ben Alexander!
Ben Alexander making his way to the ring after his loss against Kevin Owens at Takedown in a wondrous spectacle of a match. Ethan Alexander coming up short, but in the end, looking like a true warrior. But he looks to get back on track with a win and qualifying in the Battle of the Gods match. But to do it, he has to go up against a wrestling veteran and ACH.
And here's a poem from Austin, Texas, on the 190 pounds, ACH.
And when you see this man come down the ring, you see the things this man can do in that ring. It's absolutely amazing. It's a show every single time he's in the arena. And you can bet whenever ACH finds himself in a big match situation like this one, he's going to deliver everything he's got. And so is Ethan Alexander. I cannot wait for a match between these two high flyers. This one is going to be exciting. See ACH getting this crowd all pumped up as we begin our second match of the night. Ethan Alexander taking on ACH. As the ref rings the bell, here we go. This is a Battle of the Gods qualifying match. You see these two just now going to lock up in the middle of the ring. ACH with the side headlock. Now Ethan Alexander going to push him off, sends him into the ropes. Ducks down, leapfrogs over. Oh, and look at the height of that back body drop by Ethan Alexander, showing a little bit of strength there. Now they tie up again. ACH now again back of the side headlock. Just now working on the arm. Now Ethan Alexander with a side headlock of his own. Now ACH. This time he's going to push Ethan Alexander off him, sends him into the rope, ducks down, leapfrogs over, and returns the favor with that back body drop. To show how even these two actually are. Both men trying to work on the arm of their opponent. Ethan Alexander getting out of it. Now has the wrist of ACH and bringing it back. And now ACH has the wrist of Ethan Alexander bringing it back. Now an arm bar by Ethan Alexander. And ACH getting out of it. Oh, wait a second. Oh, look at this. Oh, ACH. Oh, this is the move that he beat Roman Reigns with last time, too. Could this be it? No, Ethan Alexander getting out of it. On a crucifix pin by Ethan Alexander. I'm getting one count there. Now an inside cradle by Ethan Alexander cover. Doesn't even get a one this time. On an O'Connor roll with that bridge cover. One, two, no! Oh. You see Ethan Alexander putting all of his body weight into that bridge. And ACH having the power to escape out of it. And now an O'Connor roll by ACH this time. But oh, gets transitioned into an O'Connor roll by Ethan Alexander. Now Ethan Alexander going off the ropes. Oh, gets caught with an arm drag. And another arm drag by ACH. And ACH, oh, and what an elbow drop. Into a pin. Cover. One, two, no. Take a lot more to take out Ethan Alexander so far in this match. Wait a second. Oh my god! A poison Frankenstein on the top of the head of Ethan Alexander. That's definitely gonna do some damage. And now what is this? On a neck breaker into a float over pin cover. Two, oh, it doesn't even get a two. Even after that poison Frankensteiner out of nowhere, that was absolutely disgusting. Now what is this? A side chin lock by ACH here. Looks like an Ethan Alexander now getting out of it. Ethan Alexander now kicking the legs. Ooh. Ethan Alexander coming back with those kicks. Now what is this? Ducks down. Leapfrogs over. Oh, into a Hurricane Rana. Into the pin. One. Oh, wait a second. ACH getting out of it. One. Oh, and here comes Ethan Alexander. And a kick out by ACH. What an exchange by these two. Hit the tap. Now, Ethan Alexander off the ropes. And a standing enziguri. A nice enziguri by Ethan Alexander. Sends ACH into the corner. Where's this now? In the corner. And Ethan Alexander, nice Astro Whip. Hurricane Rana. Now again, back on the middle rope. ACH slowly getting back to his feet. Oh my gosh, I think he just stepped on the chest. He just stomped on the middle of that chest and brings ACH down. And a kick to the head, a little bit of disrespect. ACH now fighting back with a chop and a couple of forearms there. Sends ACH onto the corner. Now what is this? Now has ACH and brings him down to the mat. And Alexander now lifts this. Ethan Alexander. And look at the agility by Ethan Alexander with two moonsaults. Cover goes for a pin. Could this be it? One, two. No, not yet. Ethan Alexander absolutely surprised that was not the end of the match. Now brings the head down, brings ACH's head down. Now what is he thinking here? Up on the middle rope once again. Oh, and a nice swanton bomb. Cover. One, two. No, not yet. Ethan Alexander going off the rails. So trying to go for an enziguri. Our shining wizard not happening. And now a crucifix pin by ACH. But he's too close to the ropes there. Now sends Ethan Alexander off the ropes. Ducks down. And hits him with that drop kick. And now ACH all fired up here. And here comes Ethan Alexander not having any luck as ACH takes him down with that arm drag. Ethan Alexander back to his feet, only get taken down with another arm drag, and now Ethan Alexander escaping the ring and telling people, oh, look how smart I am. But wait a second, ACH! ACH! Out of nowhere, with that corkscrew crossbody to the outside, completely catching Ethan Alexander off guard. ACH now, going up top. Wait a second, Ethan Alexander already back to his feet. Catches ACH with that punch. And now it looks like Ethan Alexander is the one going up top. But now ACH catching him. Now what's this? ACH now has Ethan Alexander in a dangerous position here. Oh my goodness, what a superplex. A nice superplex, and ACH telling these fans to get off their seats and get on their feet. And what's this? Oh my goodness, what a clothesline from the top rope, taking Ethan Alexander's head completely off. Ethan Alexander in a bad way here. ACH now has him up, fisherman suplex. And ACH could be looking for that 450 splash. That 450 splash. Here he goes. No! ACH. Not able to hit that 450. And now Ethan Alexander looks like he's setting up for the end. No. Oh, wait a second. What's this? Springboard. Oh, springboard stutter. A springboard stutter from Ethan Alexander, now picks him up, and now, oh my goodness, snapmare driver. A snapmare driver from Ethan Alexander to and it's over. What a match between these two. Both of them seemed evenly matched in the early stages of the match. And for the most part, it just kept going back and forth. But it was Ethan Alexander at the end. ACH was not able to hit that 450 splash. And because of it, Ethan Alexander was able to take advantage and hit him with a springboard stunner of all moves. And then with a snapmare driver, sending his head down to the mat, getting the 1, 2, 3.
Ethan Alexander
moves on to the Battle of the Gods match coming soon. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a quick break, but once we come back, there will be more Battle of the Gods qualifying rounds. Who is going to make it into the Battle of the Gods match coming Battle of the Gods, and a grudge match between AJ Styles and Moose of feud going back to the ZCW Christmas special. Stay tuned, everyone. You're not gonna want to miss this one.
There's a Battle of the Gods qualifying match, scheduled for one fall, coming down to the ring first, from Denver, Colorado, weighing at 245 pounds, Zaiah Steel!
Welcome back to ZCW, everyone, as we get ready for more Battle of the Gods qualifying matches, as we come in now, first, with the leader of the Nerd Squad, Zaiah Steel, making his way down to the ring, getting pumped and ready, whatever words you want to call it, as ever. See him coming down, you see that look on his face, he's pumped, he's ready to take on his opponent, whoever it may be. These rounds are completely done by random, but either way, Zaiah Steel getting ready for his opponent, getting ready to see who it is.
And his opponent, from Cleveland, Ohio, weighing at 190 pounds, Johnny Gargano!
And a surprise for Zaiah Steel it is. You got Mr. Johnny Wrestling, Johnny Gargano, making his way to the ring. Gargano making his, I think it's his third appearance here in ZCW. Now trying to go for the Battle of Gods qualifying match. And who knows, we may be seeing a future ZCW champion in Johnny Gargano if he can win this match and win the Battle of the Gods match at Battle of the Gods. But to do that, he's got to go up against 245 pound striking machine that is Zaiah Steel, as they lock up, side headlock by Johnny Gargano, and now working the arms, the wrist more specifically, of Zaiah Steel. Zaiah Steel now getting out of it and transitions into a side headlock of his own. Zaiah Steel gonna take him down, sprinting back on that side headlock and a punch straight to the head. Zaiah Steel gonna take Gargano, sends him off the ropes, and a shoulder tackle takes down takes down Johnny Gargano. Now off the ropes again into another shoulder tackle. And Zaiah Steele's like, bring it on. Zaiah Steele with I believe a 55-pound weight advantage over Johnny Gargano, but Johnny Gargano with more of an experience factor over Zaiah Steele. And Zaiah Steele getting out of that one, and Johnny Gargano using that veteran-like experience to take advantage over the rookie, and now into a schoolboy kicking out by. Oh, and another! Oh, that's another standing enziguri. We saw one of those during the Ethan Alexander's match with ACH. Now Johnny Gargano trying to put Zaiah Steele in the corner, but Zaiah Steele getting out of it puts Gargano into the corner instead. Now hits him with those punches. And now just gonna stomp a mud hole into Gargano. Zaiah Steele now picking up Johnny Gargano. Oh my goodness, what a spine buster. Into a pin. One, only a one count. Kind of surprising, that was an absolutely disgusting spine buster by Zaiah Steele. Now you can see elbow straight to the chest. Now picking up Gargano. Johnny Gargano's style of wrestling is so unorthodox. He's very technical. He's also very fast. He can go. He can high fly. He's just an all-around great wrestler, but Zaiah Steele going to use those strikes to his advantage. Better striking game Zaiah Steele has than Johnny Gargano, I have to say that. Now, Johnny Gargano picking up Zaiah Steele. Now working the arm. Now going after the leg work, going after every body part he can to take down Zaiah Steele. And when you're working with a man that's bigger than you, the kind of things you have to deal with. What's this? Oh my goodness! He just started his head into that mat with that DDT. One, two. Oh my goodness! I am surprised that didn't end it. Oh, and an elbow to the head. Zaiah Steele now again fighting back. Punches to the head. Wait, Gargano blocking that punch. And now Gargano coming back. Now Zaiah Steele. What's this? Oh, trying to go for another shoulder tackle. Johnny Gargano getting out of it. Trying to go for a clothesline. Not happening. Now Johnny Gargano. What's this? Oh my goodness. Look at that. Take out by Zaiah Steele. After that sunset flip powerbomb, only gets caught with the Shining Wizard after that though. And Johnny Gargano, he knows he has this match exactly where he wants it. And now it's this, again, working over that arm. What if this has, oh my goodness, look at the strength of Gargano here. Has a high cross powerbomb, oh my god! Into the corner, into the turnbuckle, one, two, no, Jesus, that was absolutely insane. Now Gargano going up on the middle rope, what's this, oh, and a double axe handle. Gargano in full control of this one. Wait a second, as soon as I say that, they still put them back. Oh wait, schoolboy by Gargano, kick out by Zaiah Steele. Zaiah Steele now fighting back again. Zaiah Steele keeps coming back. He keeps fighting. You gotta give him credit for that. Oh, and a huge punch to the head sends Gargano outside of the ring. Zaiah Steele now has this match in his favor. Has this match where he wants it. Wait a second. Johnny Gargano catches that kick. Oh my god, what a super kick! A super kick by Johnny Gargano now sends Zaiah Steele into the ring once again. And now Gargano pushing him back. Oh, what a shoulder block. Usually when he does that, he usually goes for a spear, but this time he decided to go for a shoulder block from the top rope. Two. No. What a hard-hitting match between these two. Now Johnny Gargano going up top. Zaiah still catching him there. Zaiah still now punching away at Johnny Gargano. Gargano kicks back Zaiah still. Now look at this! Oh, and a spear from the top rope! There's that spear I was talking about, but he said to go for it from the top rope this time, and now at least Gargano thinking up here. He'd be looking for the Hurts Donut. The Hurts Donut. Nope. Zaiah still now, look at this. Picks him up. Oh, and a back body drop. Uh-oh. What is Zaiah still looking for here? Telling Gargano to get back to his feet. What is this? Oh, here comes the Tiger Suplex of Death. The Tiger Suplex of Death. This has to be it. One, two, no! My goodness, Gargano kicking out. Gargano with that resiliency to kick out of the Tiger Suplex of Death, as Zaiah still likes to call it. Clothesline, another clothesline, and the three clotheslines by Zaiah Steel. Usually after that, here he comes with the multiple elbows straight to the head of Johnny Gargano. And now getting back up. Oh! Huge body splash into the corner. And that usually sets up for the end. And Johnny Gargano is in no man's land. Here comes, no wait, jawbreaker by Johnny Gargano. And now look at this. Oh, what is this? Gargano with the Gargano escape. The Gargano escape. The modified crossface by Johnny Gargano. Zaiah Steel in a lot of trouble. Is Zaiah Steel going to tap? Yes, he does. Johnny Gargano gets Zaiah Steel that tap. And Johnny Gargano qualified for the Battle of the Gods match. An unexpected win here tonight by Johnny Gargano at the last stretch. Just when Zaiah Steel looked like he was going to put this one away, Johnny Gargano, you know, using technical savvy or just basic smarts to just find a way to keep fighting and in the end, locked in that Gargano escape and got Zaiah Steel to count.
Johnny Gargano!
Johnny Gargano with his first win in ZCW qualifies for the Battle of the Gods match. And could we be seeing the man who will win the Battle of the Gods match come Battle of the Gods?
Your fan console is scheduled for one fall. Find out who is for. Find Don't Go Dragon Ring at 215 pounds. The phenomenal AJ Styles!
And here comes the phenomenal AJ Styles getting ready for this red match against Moose, who, if you remember at the ZCW Christmas special, cost AJ Styles the ZCW World Championship against his match against Kazuchika Okada. So AJ Styles looking for some well-needed revenge that he hasn't been able to get against Moose. But now he finally has his chance in this grudge match tonight. And we see, but as you can see, AJ Styles probably not in the best of shape right now. Not 100%, as you can see, he is all taped up here. He's got to get ready for the match.
And here's the opponent. Being coming today by Kazuchika Okada. From Washington, D.C., weighing in at 295 pounds. Moose!
Moose. Yeah, 300 pounds. That near 300-pound enforcer employed by Kazuchika Okada. And when I say enforcer, I mean he's just a guy who's there to lay down Okada's law whenever Okada sees fit. There's a problem Okada has. Moose is usually the one to deal with it. He's been perfect in that role so far. You know, it's going to be a tough challenge for AJ Styles, especially now with him not being 100% after his match at Takedown. It's going to be a real tough time for AJ. See this crowd already. You can see the look on AJ's face. You can tell he's confident in his abilities to beat Moose, but will that be enough to actually get the job done? As you can see now, Moose is trapping AJ Styles into the corner, and now Moose going on the attack on AJ. Moose is not a man of he's a man of very few words, but he's a man that likes to take action. Right, and he's a man that, I would say, likes to beat down on his opponents. And now Moose gonna stomp away at AJ. And what's this? Oh, goodness gracious, just brings his head down straight to the mat. His whole body crashing forward, or downward, I should say. Oh, and again. His whole upper body, his head just slammed straight down into the mat. And now AJ Styles trying to find some space here, but only gets caught with a back body drop. It's that upper midsection in the chest and the back area that's gonna be the absolute target of Moose during this entire match. I can tell you that. And now Moose unable to get back. Oh, and we need to kick him back into his chest. AJ came into this match knowing he had a huge target on his back, or should I say around his entire upper body. But he didn't care. He wanted this match against Moose. You know, it was a handicap match between AJ Styles and Seth Rollins taking on Moose. But again, thanks to interference by Okada, AJ Styles is still not able to get his revenge on Moose. As Moose just completely clobbers AJ into that corner cover. No. AJ getting the shoulder up. And a kick to the back again. So once AJ got the news that he could finally take on Moose in this one-on-one match, you know, he didn't care if he was 100%. He took the match. He said he was ready for Moose. But now I'm not too sure. As you can see, Moose has just had full control of this match. Now, AJ in a seated position only to get kicked back down. And again, the shoulder and the chest, upper midsection area being targeted by Moose. But it's killing him so far, as Moose again with another bulldog. Kick to the shoulder. Moose knows exactly what he's doing. Moose knows that he had the advantage going into this match, and now tries to go for another clothesline. AJ getting out of it this time. And now AJ going on the attack on Moose. Look at the kick by AJ. And now fighting back against Moose. Oh, wait a second. Moose now with a four. Oh, what a drop kick from the near 300-pound Moose. Cover. Two. No. What a drop kick by this gigantic man. Now what is he doing on the middle rope? On the middle rope, here comes Moose, and a double axe handle. Completely crowning AJ with that one. Now AJ Styles in big trouble. Wait a second. Gets out of the sidewalk slam. Turns it. Oh, hits him with that float over DDT. And now AJ getting some adrenaline here. And hits him with a sling blade. Some well-needed offense by AJ here. Tries to go for a drop kick, but doesn't take down Moose. And now he's just trying again. And a kick. Oh my goodness. And look at these strikes by AJ. Now what is this? AJ Styles Pele kick. Now Moose is finally down, but AJ is not done. AJ, what is he thinking here? Oh my goodness! Springboard! 450 splash! And this could be it. This could be it for Moose. Cover two, and no! AJ thought he had this one. Had this one won. But the ref said it was not to be. Or at least not yet. Now AJ sends Moose off the ropes into another sling blade. AJ now just waiting for Moose to get back to his feet. And now what is this? Oh my goodness! Springboard Moose into a reverse DDT! AJ. AJ's athleticism. Oh, wait a second. Moose rolling out of that dropkick and hits him with another bulldog. AJ's down. And now Moose has AJ right where he wants him. And Moose setting him up. And here comes the spear. Wait a second. No, schoolboy by AJ Styles. Cover two. No. Moose kicking out. And now AJ going to work on Moose. Not able to hit that enziguri. Takes him down with the arm drag. Moose now. Oh, and another drop kick. And now Moose. Oh, he's setting him up. He is setting him up for that spear. Can he hit it though? Oh no! Reverses into a DDT, does AJ Styles. And now AJ looking for the Styles Clash perhaps. The Styles Clash. Wait a second. No, never mind. Turns him over for the Calf Crusher. The Calf Crusher. Is Moose going to tap out to the Calf Crusher by AJ? Is Moose in trouble here? No. I think Moose was able to get his foot near the bottom of that rope somehow. And now AJ, he could be looking for that phenomenal forearm. That phenomenal forearm AJ Styles is known for. Here he comes, phenomenal forearm by AJ Styles. And now AJ, now I'm gonna set up for that Styles Clash. The Styles Clash by AJ, no, jawbreaker by Moose, and now Moose drop kick once again to the chest. And this one could be it. One, two, no! What unbelievable resiliency by AJ Styles in this one. This crowd is on their feet. Now AJ going after Moose. AJ now striking away at the back of the head of Moose. And Moose sends a knee straight to the gut of AJ. Now off the rocks. Spear! Spear! Spear out of nowhere! A spear out of nowhere! A spear by Moose! Two! And it's over! Moose getting the upset victory over AJ Styles. AJ said he wanted this match. He got the match. But I have to believe if he were in 100% condition, the result of this one might have been a little bit different. But in the end, it was Moose hitting him with that spear out of nowhere and getting the win. So now that Moose has won, what does this loss do to the morality of AJ Styles? Well, here comes the new ZCW Champion, Seth Rollins, after that huge win at Takedown in the triple threat match against him, Styles, and Okada. Seth Rollins being able to take advantage of Okada after Okada hit the Rainmaker on Styles. Okada was not aware of Rollins in the ring, and Rollins took advantage, sent Okada outside of the ring, got the pin on AJ Styles, and then becoming the new ZCW World Champion. So a great win by Seth Rollins, but now he has to look towards Battle of the Gods as he gets ready for his rematch against Kazuchika Okada. Here comes the man Seth Rollins was just talking about, the former ZCW champion, Kazuchika Okada. You can see the look on his face. He is not a happy person right now. He feels like he was cheated out of that match, out of that triple threat match. He wasn't even pinned for his title, for him to lose his title. He's claiming Seth Rollins to be a thief, a no good criminal, who stole his title, and at Battle of the Gods, he is going to be the one to take it back and bring Seth Rollins to justice. But God only knows what he is out here for right now. Okada just punched Seth Rollins straight in the face and now turns him around for the Rainmaker! Okada making the message pretty clear that this one at Battle of the Gods is personal. It's the third match in the series. Okada, Rollins, one-on-one. Can Rollins finally be able to pin Kazuchika Okada? Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. And as we get ready for the main event of the evening, it is now time to tell you what you can expect on the next episode of ZCW on YouTube. In the next episode, we will have more Battle of the Gods qualifying rounds. You can see more men qualifying for the Battle of the Gods match at Battle of the Gods to see who will become the number one contender to face the ZCW champion at this day we fight. Also, the tag team champions, the ZCW tag team champions, Darren Kane and Baron Corbin, will hold an open challenge for Battle of the Gods to any tag team out there in the ZCW roster that has enough guts to face these two at Battle of the Gods for the ZCW Tag Team Championship. Also, Roman Reigns explains his actions on why he did what he did to Shinsuke Nakamura. Why Shinsuke in particular, and why did he single Shinsuke out? We will find that out, hopefully, on the next episode of ZCW on YouTube. And also, a special match has been added as Kota Ibushi and Sydal take on Finn Balor and Sami Callihan. Sami Callihan is going to face Finn Balor for the number one contendership for the ZCW Pride Championship at Battle of Gods. But next episode, they are teaming to take on the team of Sydal and Ibushi. Biggest name in professional wrestling to date.
And his opponent, the Big Mahal, weighing at 238 pounds,
tonight is one of Brayton Goldman's biggest nights in his career. He has the chance to not only qualify for the Battle of the Gods match at Battle of the Gods, but he also has the chance to do it at the expense of John Cena. There is a chance that Brayton Goldman could get a big victory over John Cena and qualify for the Battle of the Gods match. That is easier said than done. And I think Brayton Goldman knows this. Brayton Goldman, I know that once he got the word, he's been waiting for this moment, he's been training, he's been strategizing just how he should go over this. Because Cena is not any other wrestler. John Cena is one of the most resilient, never giving up attitude. He never gives up. It's going to be a tough one. We'll just keep it at that, ladies and gentlemen. It's going to be a tough battle for Brayton Goldman. These two sizing each other up. Brayton Goldman now with the side headlock. This is our main event of the evening, ladies and gentlemen. Brayton Goldman taking on John Cena as Brayton Goldman takes down John Cena early with that clothesline. You can see the stare down. You can see Brayton Goldman looking to the eyes of Cena. He's saying, I got you. I know what I have to do to beat you. Problem is that Can he do it? As he tries, oh, and gets hit with a drop kick by Cena. Dead in each other's eyes. As now Braun Strowman takes down Cena with a side headlock takedown, and now just gonna wrench back on that head. He's gonna wrench as much as he can on Cena. And Cena picks him back up and transition to a side headlock of his own. And Cena gonna wrench the head of Braun Strowman as well. Now Braun Strowman. Oh, look at this. Braun Strowman now using his strength, that unbelievable strength that he has to push Cena off of him. Ducks down. Leapfrogs over. That's that agility as well. And a huge hip toss by Braun Strowman. And now just screaming at the top of his lungs. He's a beast. There's a reason they call him the Tiny Tank. This man is as powerful as they come, as you can see as he hits Cena with that shoulder tackle. 5'8", 238 pounds. Don't let the size fool you. This man can run over almost anyone. Don't even get a one count there. Like I said, it's going to be a tough hill to climb for Braun Strowman. Cena is not one to take lightly. Braun Strowman knows this, and he's going to use his amateur wrestling background style on Cena and see if that works. But Cena now going to use those hands, those strikes to the head, but gets caught with a back body drop by Braun Strowman. Braun Strowman is also going to use that strength. Now, we heard Cena say, pound for pound, he is one, pound for pound, Braun Strowman is one of the strongest men Cena's ever seen. Wait a second, look at this! Oh my goodness, look at that! Reversal arm drag that Cena there. It looked like Braun Strowman was going to hit him with a double underhook suplex, but no prevail. Cena just clotheslines Braun Strowman, just going to get stomped away. Braun Strowman getting out of it, and a kick to the back. Both men, when you look at them, you wouldn't expect such agility from either man, but on occasions we've seen that Cena, you know, he has a lot more moves in his arsenal that people don't like to give him credit for. And Braun Strowman, when you see a man like his size, you don't expect him to be as agile as some people think, but he's surprisingly very agile. Now Braun Strowman just waiting for Cena to get back to his feet, and now look at this, back suplex, high up in the air, sends Cena down in the middle of the ring. Braun Strowman now picking up Cena, an exploder suplex. Braun Strowman getting himself all pumped up. He is staying focused. He has had his eyes on Cena ever since the match began. Oh, wait a second. Cena sends him outside of the ring. He gave Cena a little breathing room, and Cena made him pay for it. Cena kicks him down with a clothesline to the outside. Cena now going to take Braun Strowman back into the ring. Now what's this? Has him up. Wait a second. Braun Strowman now with a German suplex to the back of his head. The back of the head and neck of John Cena. And now picks him up and just slams him down. Cover. One. Only a one count. Now Braun Strowman back into the side chin lock. Wrenching back on Cena. Wait a second, Cena again fighting out of it. A couple of elbows to the midsection. Braun Strowman catches the leg. Catches the foot of Cena. Now has Cena brings him up. What is this? Has him up in the air. Oh my god, what a gut buster. And transitions into a camel clutch, giving Cena no time to breathe, does Braun Strowman, and that is smart. And you can see Braun Strowman has this match in his favor. Now, what is this? Oh my goodness! Oh, and not letting Cena go! All I can see is, oh, look at this. Look at the strength and the maneuverability by Brayton Goldman. Cover. One, two, no. Brayton Goldman, he is giving everything to Cena so far as he hits him with the helmet to the top of his head. He's giving Cena everything he's got. Another elbow to the back of the head of Cena. And now what is this? Brayton Goldman now. Oh my goodness, look at this. Just stretching Cena out with that abdominal stretch. Also has that leg. That leg, just bending that leg all types of ways. Doesn't want to be bent, but Cena getting out of it. Catching Brayton Goldman with that hip toss. Now Cena. As Brayton Goldman kicked to the gut, goes for that Fishman suplex. No, Brayton Goldman getting out of it with a punch to the midsection. And now, German suplex by Brayton Goldman. You can hear this crowd. Whether they like Cena or they hate him, Cena's always getting a big time response from every crowd he goes in front of. Brayton Goldman gonna make sure this one's not all about Cena, that he is in this match too, as you can see him now with a crossface in the middle of the ring, but Cena obviously not gonna give up here. Cena obviously known for not giving up in big match situations, and now go! Oh my god, just completely checked Brayton Goldman with that shoulder block. Brayton Goldman now sends Cena into the corner though. And look at this! This is the agility of Brayton Goldman I was talking about with that springboard crossbody cover. Two! No! That's that agility that I was talking about with Brayton Goldman. He is very surprisingly agile for a man his size. Cena about. Wait a second, Cena picks him up, attitude adjustment on Brayton Goldman, cover, one, two, no, oh my god, that was close. Brayton, he just hit Brayton Goldman with that attitude adjustment. Now look at Cena, oh, and Brayton Goldman just shoulder blocks Cena this time, and now what is this, cravat suplex by Brayton Goldman. Brayton Goldman immediately, what is this? Capture suplex! A capture suplex by Brayton Goldman. Two, no, and Cena still kicking out. Cena still in this one, and Brayton Goldman cannot believe it. And now, oh my goodness, what a side suplex by Brayton Goldman. What is Goldman thinking up here? And a kick to the chest. You know, that has to be out of frustration a little bit. Cena has been known to get most of his opponents very frustrated. Anyone who has gotten in the ring with Cena knows he is a hard man to put down. As Cena tried to go for that hard punch, bring Goldman off the ropes. Cena catches him with the Hurricane Rana! Cover! One, two, no! And now Cena setting him up. Could he possibly be looking for that comeback? Yes, he does it. Here comes Cena. Ducks the line into a proto bomb. And now Cena looking towards the crowd and then looking at Brayton Goldman. You can't see me. And hits him with a little five-knuckle shuffle. And now this could be the end for Brayton Goldman. This could be the end. This could be all she wrote for Brayton Goldman as he has him up. No, Brayton Goldman fighting out. And now Brayton Goldman has him again. Capture suplex. Another capture suplex by Brayton Goldman. Now what is this? Northern Light suplex. Wait a second. Oh my goodness, look at this. It transitions into, oh my goodness, Brainbuster. Cover. One, 2! No! What a match this has been! And now Cena going right after Ben Goldman, dropkick to the back! Ben Goldman now back to his feet! Oh! Just trips up Cena there! Now has the legs of Cena. What is this? What is he doing here? Oh, look at this! He's got him in a leg lock! A leg lock of some sort! And just reaching back on that leg of Cena! Brian Goldman's trying everything he can, but to no avail. Cena is not giving up. And now belly-to-belly suplex! Hitting him with suplexes, hitting him with submission holds. What else could he do? Oh, wait a second. What's this? What is this? Oh my goodness, look at this! A little tribute to the Swiss Superman Cesaro with that huge swing. Look at him just... Oh my goodness! Just swinging him around all across the ring, only to bring him back down. And Brayden Goldman is fired up. Brayden Goldman, now what is he doing? He's going up top. He is going up top. Here comes Brayden Goldman with the senton. No! But Cena got out of the way. Cena got out of the way. And now Cena now taking advantage. Fisherman suplex. And now picking up Brayden Goldman again. What's this? Oh, and another kick to the gut, and another fisherman suplex. Oh my goodness. This looks wildly familiar to the offense that he used to beat Mil Muertes at Takedown with three fisherman suplexes. And now immediately picking up Brayden Goldman, picks him up, has him up in the air, and with that pendulum face buster straight to the mat. Again, like I said, very wildly similar to that offense that he gave to Mil Muertes in their last standing match of Takedown. But Brayden Goldman taking out, still fighting back, still in this one. Wait a second, catching Cena! Oh my goodness, wheelbarrow, German suplex. A star-making performance from Brayden Goldman here tonight, if I do say so myself. Picks up Cena, no, Cena going back, German suplex by John Cena. And now John, oh, it looked like he was going for the SCF, but Brayden goes back to his feet, and an attitude adjustment, the second attitude adjustment by John Cena, and now goes for a pin cover. 1, 2, it's over. John Cena and Brayden Goldman just gave these fans one hell of a treat tonight. These men gave it everything they had, especially Brayden Goldman. You gotta give him credit. He came as a rookie. He left this match a star against John Cena. He pulled out every move in his repertoire to beat John Cena. But John Cena once again proving why he is a franchise, why he is a 15-time world champion, is because of performances like that. Cena getting the big win and qualifying for the Battle of the Gods match at Battle of the Gods. Cena qualifying for Battle of the Gods. It's gonna be a tough time. It's gonna be one hell of a time for anyone who tries to oppose this man in the Battle of the Gods match. Cena is looking for that CCW champion. And I thought it's good luck to anyone trying to get in his way. Thank you everyone for watching. I will see you next time. This has been Zaiah Morgan, and I will see you later.